There you go. Off to a brilliant start. But that's all right. That's all right. We'll have that loaded up eventually. Either way, is Keanu Reeves blowing stuff up? That's what I like to see.
Indeed. So basically, his poor wife passed away. She left us, DDK. But she also left him a small dog. And then some dudes came and killed his dog. And now he's really angry. He wants revenge. Indeed he does.
And it's Keanu Reeves, so he's going to go through a long, long extent to get that revenge and as many explosions. It's going to be good.
Yeah, you can see some of those explosions behind us. Yeah, hopefully the trailer will be ready to show you a bit later on, but I think we have almost all the players finally on the server. We're going to switch into the game now, and we will be on Dust2, as previously mentioned.
Exactly, and Dust2, of course, it's the classic Mac. Everybody knows Dust2. So it's more or less... all to be played for. We're going to have to see how things just go and learn about these teams and how they play Dust2 as things progress. And also, of course, as it's a domestic affair, we're going to probably see a lot of similarity when it comes to, a lot of familiarity. There we go, got the right itty word. As Savage and Area 51, I'm sure, have played much together. And it always changes the dynamic if you already have a comfort in a matchup, even if you don't win all the time, just knowing some of the deadly tricks of that team can certainly help your ability not to get caught by them and certainly give you a better chance than perhaps otherwise.
On the subject of changes, a player from Area 51 Nitro did join Netcode Guides, and Mo will be playing for Area 51 today. I believe he used to be in the team and has returned to the team. So we are going to start with the knife round, guys. So the knife round will decide who starts on which team. The winners of the knife round will get the choice here. So again, Area 51 versus Savage. Knife round will take place on long. Let's see who wins this. And one thing about this lineup from the Savage team, they have a player called Glorins. And every time I see his name, I think Glorious. So I'm just going to call him Glorious Glorins now.
Glorious Glorins. I'm also a fan of alliteration, so I appreciate the use of that. I like your choice. You have taste, James.
I'm a man of panache.
What does panache mean?
I am not to be trifled with, DDK.
You said this earlier. I don't know what panache means. We didn't look it up in the break.
I'm not to be trifled with.
But I get that, but what does panache mean?
I'm not to be trifled with, DDK.
Are you trying to insinuate that by asking what that means, I'm currently trifling with you without even realizing it? Unintentional trifling. We're not for that here.
I hope for your sake you're not.
That's okay. Really ambiguous.
I'm going to give you a definitive definition of panache. But not right now, because
not
it's
right
a pistol
now.
Round.
I knew you were going to say that. You cop out, you. All right, so we're into the match now as Savage start off on the terrorist side against Area 51 to begin this best of three in the John Wick Invitational. And they are to make their way through Upper Dark to begin with, as we do have Hades wrapping around towards short. And nice little boost coming in there. Mo going to find himself at the mercy of Hades' Glock, and we are going to see the kills return from Disciples HE. So things are looking quite good. Potentially, oh, that was a nasty bit of work there from Aria onto her relics. They do make their way onto the bomb site, and still it's a 3-on-3. Still so much to play for. That's beautiful there by Abe with the USP. And Vanas pops out from the barrel. Doesn't like what he sees. Tries to fall back, but it looks like Aria's having none of that. And Aria with another one as well. Beautiful triple there from Aria. And we will see ourselves an Area 51 victory on the pistol.
Flamboyant confidence of style. Panache. Let's do this.
You dictionary.com that whilst I was commentating. That
I
is...
did.
Indeed. Well, I approve.
The people had to know, DDK.
I had to know.
People wanted answers. I had to give it to
them.
What
was it again? Flamboyant something or other?
Confidence of style.
All right, panache. Fair enough.
Let's
go. Well then. We are going to see the CZ. Just the CZ. And no more CZs than one. So, not many CZs. So they shouldn't be afraid. But there are the PT-50s as well. And they are something to be feared for and respected as well. They're going to make the bust out onto long at the moment. Disciple's going to get immediately taken care of, and that's going to be if Alice taken. And I see Aria getting boosted up there. Mo is going to be the one who is doing the boosting, has to pound through the smoke some. Abe's going to join in as well, but that's going to leave poor Aria isolated there. Does get taken down by Valens. They're putting in some damage, but this should not be happening right now.
Indeed, and it's going to be the CC going for the retake here. It is a FAMAS on the T side, and it's doing work here as only Nozzle remains, and he's got no helmet as well, which means one shot to the head and he will be dead. Gets tagged, 71 HP remaining, up against two. The crossfire is real here. Hades going to bait for the minute long. He knows this one along. And again, there's that headshot coming in there with a P250 as well, which is armor piercing, but there is no armor on his head. And interesting choice there for Area 51 not to go with helmets against the eco of Savage there in the second round.
Yeah, it was definitely quite a disaster, to say the least. Savage going to be returning to prominence in this game. There's a peak, and he does manage to find himself, actually, the damage. So he did see the headshot counter pop in there at the top right. If you missed that, check that out later on. As they do make their way into the bomb site, Abe with a great angle will take down one player with the help of Nozzle. That's two down. Make that three and four, and they're all falling like dominoes to the defense here on the B bomb site, and they get reversed. Eco now, so it's absolute madness at the beginning of this game. And yeah, like Mo's gonna say, is this game real life? Well, I can certainly understand his sentiment.
Indeed, and you can see we have a special headshot counter here for this tournament. John Wick, I'm sure, is a purveyor of headshots, and we will find out if he is or not on Friday. Again, Area 51 bringing things back to how they should be after winning the pistol. Going to make it 2-1. Aria getting a shot on Hades through the doors onto the leg. And they leave him with 16 HP, so Hades one shot away from meeting his fate in this particular round. But for now, he's still alive, but at a one-man disadvantage on Savage. It's going to be another headshot onto Abe. There is another man on the middle, though. And he gets a headshot on him as well. Hades going huge here with all of 16 HP.
Yeah, this is beautiful work. We saw lots of this from Angel actually earlier today, just busting up middle with on the dusty pushes. And it's something he's quite good at. And looks like Hades is also racking up the frags from that. That creates a lot of opportunities for his team, as Area 51 are on the rifles. But once again, they're actually struggling. It seems like the team that should be an advantage is suddenly struggling. But they do have an even situation on the players. More health, better weapons. Card going to come in now through onto the B-bomb. So they're going to take down Nozzle, as we do see the bomb get planted. This is quite crazy. Card could go for a quick one-on-one challenge. It does spot the player moving towards the double doors. But there goes the flash over the top as Disciples looking for the shot. Another flash in to slow his approach. As Cut goes for the peak, spots a single player. Mo is slowly behind and Lawrence in the corner. Gonna get the distraction, the opportunity for both headshots, and he's gonna find it, just needing a P250, and neither team can hold on to the advantage at all. Absolutely ridiculous stuff here. I love it. I like it. I want some more of it.
Glorious. From Glorin's there. I feel the cringe from what I just said. I'm cringing myself, but never mind. It is 2-2 here. These teams all square at the moment. Aria going to be looking in mid with the scout once again. We have an aggressive push here from the ecoing CCs. Ecoing meaning they are buying a very limited weaponry in this round. Keep things economical so they can go for a full buy in the following round. Glorin's going to pop Disciple's head, going to survive with all of 16 HP. These guys like to pick people when they've got next to no life remaining. You see that flashbang just in case there. On the B bomb site, Relix is going to take down Abe. And the last man standing is going to be Aria. Going for the jumping frag with the scout. Not going to find anything though. It's going to be almost a clean sweep there for Savage. Only Kud going down.
So finally, could this be normality restored? That's what I'm going to ask you. Is normality restored?
Well, we're about to find out. I mean,
well, we saw Savage actually win the round with the advantage, so already.
Yeah, we've got the force buy here from the CTs, and we're going to have a three-man push up mid. This is crazy. We've got Nozzle leading the charge here. Again, we've got a lack of helmets. Mo with the AWP and no armor whatsoever, so they're really going all out here to win this round.
Beautiful find there by Relix with the snap onto Nozzle's head. We'll find Aria at the top of middle. Catches him with a nade up, but it's going to be Relix who goes down, in fact, as Abe is going to take a bit of a peek, work his way in, and then back out again. They have yet to find the last couple players, but one of them, Valens, is making his way down the shore. This could be quite painful, but they do find him, and he's not able to even respond before he gets taken down. More headshots to follow as Hades is going to find his way around to top middle, but there's 50 seconds left, so quite a good chunk of time for him to play with. This mid aggression largely very effective here for Area 51.
The interesting thing is, nobody knows where anybody else is right now. He has no idea where the CTs are. They could be anywhere, and vice versa.
That smoke actually might just help him. It does help him indeed. And he's going to get the frag onto Arya, make his way through the doors, and there's Abe greeting him, welcoming him with the FAMAS, and another headshot to be found there. And we're going to see that it's going to be Area 51 picking up that round with the crazy aggression. Seems like that's all they needed.
Indeed. And Mo now going for the full armor on AWP. Hades is going to try and get a frag through the gap, but nothing to be found just yet. We're going to have Mo holding the angle on short, so if the CTs, or if the terrorists try and push through to short, then Mo is going to be having a butchers with that AWP. So we see the rotation of a CT towards A long. Going to see some action there from the T's shooting through the doors. He's going to offer support to his teammate just in case he needs it, but there will be no connection from either side just yet. Arya has been tagged down somehow to 67 HP. He is currently playing on the A site. Still supporting his friend on long. Again, the T's just poking, trying to find someone. Relix does find Mo, but Mo will find a better of him. Take him out. Valens does take down Arya on long, so it is 4 versus 4 here with 55 seconds remaining.
Yeah, they're going to make their way up short now, so this is really well played by them. In fact, Disciple's actually going to cut off the split. Now it's just a push only with the three men who survived up short, as long control is truly in the hands of Disciple for Area 51. Push is going to come in on top of that site, and they are going to get the plant down, but where they get the plant down is really the question. Hades already getting tagged down quite low. It looks like Cut is on the flank, but they can't even get the bomb down quite yet. Looks like you can see Hades, you know, dropping down to try to make more frags before putting the bomb down. Risky business, but it is to be the plant for short in the end. And Cut can be relieved now as he was waiting for that. He is going to find himself at the duel against Moe. He actually wins that. And now Hades comes in with the AWP. It's a one-on-one. Cut taking the trade. And so they did assault his teammate. And Abe going to go for the defuse here. Is he just going to hold it? Oh, he's just going to hold it. And Card, is he going to work it out? Actually, he comes off the defuse just in time. And Card did the job. He created the threat. And that's actually going to be it. I thought he was going to go for it. But that was a marginal situation if ever I saw one.
Indeed. He had when he stopped the defuse there, that was the end of the round, basically. He didn't have the time, because of the lack of defuse kit, to defuse the bomb following that, even if he got the frag on the terrorist. So I guess he didn't want to give the terrorist free money, but he was going to get a lot of money from the bomb plant anyway. So different strokes, different folks. We do have Mo looking up short, but this time with a 5-7 rather than an AWP. We are going to see only pistols from the CCs at the moment. If they can get close enough, they could get some frags here, but Harry will get one from range with the CZ on relics. That will be a gun to the good here for the CTs, and the T's are going to get free reign on the A bomb site for the time being. See if the counter-terrorists aim for the retake here. They've got four players with nothing to lose, so I think they are going to go for the push here.
There we have a Disciple, the first man in, but also the first man out again. And he does get denied by Glorians, and there goes the smoke. So definitely a very troubling situation to be found for Area 51 on the retake. Mo going to go down Abe as well, and Nozzle to fall shortly after. As looks like Savage are definitely putting the rounds on the board, and Savage are a team that we've seen improving, you know, week in, week out, as far as we've had the privilege to get to cast their games during the portion of the Face It League, the North American portion of the Face It League, rather, should I say. As 5-3 is current score. The orb is in the hands of Arya now for Area 51. Let's see what can be done there.
Indeed, we do have the headshots coming in thick and fast in a John Wick Invitational. 24 on the counter at the moment. Hades taking out Mo. Chest shot, so that won't be another one just yet. But it's going to be Arya picking up the AWP for the CTs. An early disadvantage for them. The T's with lots of time on the clock to decide where to go, try and get another pick, and find out where the CTs are placed and exploit the weaknesses there. We're seeing a full rotation here from the CTs. If you look at your radar on the top left, all the blue dots coming towards the A bomb site. Frags coming in thick and fast. Currently, 3 versus 2, 3 versus 1. Valens, all of a sudden, the only man remaining here for the terrorist side. But he does have a Galil, which is not as powerful as the AK. That said, once again, Abe and Nozwal do not have helmets, which means if he shoots them once, in the head, they're going to die. And Arya's got no armor whatsoever. This is entirely doable. And he's picked up the AK now. This could be bad for Area 51.
Not where to look just yet. Going to commit towards that push, and there's the shot whiffed. He is trying to bait out a player to go for the flank and get the easy one-on-one. It's not quite happening just yet. Here we go, and he pulls out the grenade at the wrong moment. That's so unfortunate there. Valentin, he gets assaulted from the side. And very unfortunate timing, very unfortunate indeed, as 4-5 is now the score, and Area 51 hold on to that, and Savage certainly to be challenged now, as Area 51 look to be rising back into prominence, but they have to get one more round to force out that eco.
Indeed, you can see Savage forcing the buy now, and we're going to see the short boost here. Area's going to get a very quick position on short. He may try and go for a frag on lower mid. Well, the AWP in a strong position. He's going to run away, though. The flashes do come in. He does have support here. Misses the first shot. Doesn't manage to pull off a second. But it's going to take them. And we have a war of attrition here on Sean. He's looking to push through the smoke one by one. Disciple can't get his pistol out in time. Pulls out a grenade instead. He will force a kill as well. Moe does get the trade frag, but Glorin's getting revenge. And that's going to be 4-2 here. And the A-bombs are in control of the terrorists.
That's a great nade, actually. Does a good chunk of damage to both Aid and Noswell, as they are trying to just now survive. They've seen the terrors of war, and they want no part of it. Carrying over by the T-spawn, hoping to get airlifted out of here and to a safe place to maybe, you know, nurse some hot chocolate by the sofa instead of this desolate, barren war zone of Dust 2.
Abe and Nozzle running for their lives here. And it's quite interesting. I feel like Area 51 are a team with bags and bags of confidence, because rather than eco around and save for a situation where they can buy properly with helmets, they're just happy to go for it without the helmet. So it seems like they don't respect the aiming skills of Savage. And generally speaking, in the American scene, we see that they have a lot of brilliant aimers here. We will see heads get ripped off. And that said, Savage have a two-round advantage here. So these are... non-helmet buys might not be working here for Area 51 so far. They do go for a force buy once again. Two rifles and three pistols. They're going to need to get up close and personal with those pistols to get the advantage of the one shot to the head. Noswell, so aggressive, going to take out Valens while he's holding a grenade in his hand. And that could be an additional rifle, a very crucial, needed rifle here for Area 51.
Glorin's to get challenged, though, as they try to make the information play up a dog. But they're going to find themselves a nasty surprise. And the surprise's name is Glorin's, wielding an AK-47 and dealing in death. As Relics now is the last man on the outside with the bomb. And Area 51 know what's going on, but they still have the two M4s alive. But really, should they do this? That's what they're trying to surmise at this point in time, trying to understand whether or not it's really all that worthwhile trying to go for a retake. But so they're going to try to escape once again, but Abe is going to find himself at the mercy of Hades' AWP, as Noswell is about to be challenged. Relics, can he take him down? And there it is, blood splattered all over that barrel. It will never be the same again.
Lack of armor not going his way there. And it will be 7-4 in favor of Savage. This is the first map of potentially three today in this particular match. You can see the headshot counter just rising, rising, and rising. John Wick would definitely be proud of this one. And again, you can see the CTs have all bought pistols where if they can get close enough, despite the armor of the terrorists, they've got a CUD, they will kill them with a one shot. And that's why they're being so aggressive here, because they need to get these angles. If they can get these angles, they can potentially win the round here, and they could get the jump on the T's as they're all in lower B right now. Hades does sense something though. It's gonna go for it. Too many targets. He will get shot straight in the face there by Arya. That's gonna be another headshot for the counter. Valens getting two frags there against the unarmored opponents. Arya getting another one, trade frag on Valens.
Oh, and they thought it was safe, but they were so wrong, thinking all the players were towards the B side of the map, and that surprise push out long is gonna yield lovely results. Three frags found. The AWP on the floor, just about found by Cud, but that was certainly a nasty state of affairs. Beautiful push there from Area 51. And now Savage are going to be in store for a bit of a buy from their opponents. Where is Mo going to try to challenge there? Both players missing the tag, missing the kill. The AWP, but Mo is going to keep himself there until he gets smoked away. Not going to be boosted by a teammate to look over that smoke, so it's going to be hard. Oh, in fact, Hades is going to go for that boost on the other side, and that's going to actually allow Mo to find the frag, Oh, that is not good at all for Savage, giving Mo that opportunity. And now we're going to see what can be found for Savage, as they don't have really the men to risk now.
Mo sent Hades straight to her with that one. One of the more controversial characters in the American scene, Mo. Back in the Area 51 squad, at least for now, as their player Nitro did go over to the now ex-Netcode Guides team, going back to their original name, which I think is called Mousefaz. But anyway, it is Area 51 and Savage right now, and we've got a full push coming here on the A bomb site.
Yeah, Disciple doesn't look like he's having a very good time here, whiffing a few shots, a few too many, I should say, as he is about to get challenged by a couple of players, and there's only a single frag to be found as the rest of his teammates flurry in up the slope from crossover, only to be dropped back down heavily by Cud. Can I whiff the shot? And that might be Nozor's opportunity now, as he is stalking his prey. Cud only with 26 measly points of health as Nozor going to pull out the nade. That wasn't a good time for that. And Mo is going to be left with the responsibility, with the burden to find the shot. That's exactly what Mo is going to find with the AWP. And that's going to be the round there for Area 51 as Savage sit, though, I think happily on 8 rounds at the moment. They're going to be satisfied with that, but they can do better and they know it.
I think Area 51 is my favorite Counter-Strike team name.
It's only because you have a Deagle.
I used to love X-Files as well. I think that's why. We have a leg shot here on Disciple. And again, look at the armor on Area 51. We've only got 2 of 5 players with helmets at the moment. And we'll see. Let's look at the... it is all AKs finally for Savage, so the helmets won't matter anymore. Could is going to pop Aria in the face there. And it is going to be a 4v4 as we have Aria down for the CT side and Hades down for the T side. The bomb is going down once again. We've seen a fair few bomb plants here. Let's see how the CTs choose to retake the site.
Oh, this is going to be very nasty. Disciple spots the helmet of Valens and will swiftly pick it off, as we do have a very good situation now for Area 51 up on the bomb site, forcing them to go through the smoke. But oh no, there's a player behind you. Cut is going to cut down Disciple. And there comes the second frag, putting Mo to a very difficult task once again. He's going to go for the defuse. He's got no other choice. Oh, almost going to be able to get it. Glorians is going to be able to finish him off just in the nick of time. And that is going to be the round there for Savage, as they go 9-5 in Area 51, finding themselves in the last round with a terrible, terrible buy.
We're reaching the 50 bomb on the headshot counter, but no players on 20 just yet. Could being the closest at the moment, doing great work with the AK. And once again, we have the most, we have the latest force buy here from Area 51, a scout, an M4, 2CZ, and a dead player in Nozwell. That's going to be a close casket funeral.
In there you go. Mo wants to challenge, and challenge he will, sending Valens to an early grave, as we do have a couple players resting outside of the A longhouse now for Savage, awaiting perhaps a follow-up push, but it's not going to come. Trying to take every precaution, and Hades is going to find the head of Aria. That will open up the short approach should they choose to go up that way. And Renix might just try to see if he can find a spot through middle. It will be found in Disciple as he gets taken down. And Renix is just going to take this straight up to the B bomb site. No nonsense push coming in here now from Savage, as they are looking to make even more of a mess of Area 51. Now who are left, once again, only to put their hopes and desires into Mo against 4 players, though. I certainly don't like his odds, and in fact, he will go down for a 10-5 half for Savage. That's beautiful for them. They are off to a brilliant start.
Indeed, they will be very happy with that. And you have to wonder about the force buy tactics from Area 51 there. I wonder if they would have had a better edge had they went for a full eco and then full buys there. We will never know. So we have 43 headshots at halftime, not quite 50. We'll see if we manage to get a 50 bomb halfway through in the games that are upcoming, including the second map of this match.
Hey, James, can you quickly add up all the frags in the match and then work out what percentage that was?
What, the headshots?
Yeah, the percentage of the headshots overall.
No.
Oh, I thought you were math whiz, James.
Yeah, but I'm not Rain Man.
Oh, okay. Sorry for comparing you to Rain Man.
Oh, so you did. Terrible. Anyway, we have Area 51 on the T side now. Again, they are at a 5-round deficit. The pistol round will be important and will give them a good opportunity to keep the CTs on a low economy. We already have the flank coming in from second, from lower B. not going to yield any frags yet. And it's going to be a trade here, but it ends up in the advantage of Area 51.
Yeah, looks like it's very good here for Area 51. They have everything under control at the moment. Florian's going to go in for a bit of a peek, and he's not finding any love with the pistol just yet. And of course, picking up that kill, it's going to take a lot more than that to take this bomb plant. And Valens will go down. There's nothing he can do, as Abe is going to be rewarded with that frag. And we see Area 51 winning the pistol and giving themselves a fighting chance now against Savage, who are starting off on the CT side in the second half. But they will go for the CZ scout. Double scouts. Love it.
Indeed. Double scout, triple CZ. This is going to be an interesting one. Dust 2 is one of those maps where you can play reasonable ranges here, but attempts down mid, not going to go their way as Nozzle does get the better of Kud. Hades will get one frag, and their Relics goes for the, gets Abe down quickly, tries to get a spray down on the remaining T players, but isn't to be. It's going to be a 3 versus 3 now. Second AWP, sorry, AW scout, picked up by Valens. Let's see how they retake this with two sniper rifles.
Yeah, mostly an easy engagement there, though. And that's not a good start there for the retake. Quick switch to the Galil, though, still won't help them out, as Valens is going to try to use that scout with all of its capacities, and unfortunately for him, he's not going to find any luck with it, as we see Area 51 going 7 to the 10 of Savage, and that certainly is going to be really nice for them, because if we look at the, if we recall back to how this game started out, it was chaos and just madness personified in the first 4 to 5 rounds.
Indeed. Now, you can see the CTs are going to be forced to eco again, which means they're going to have to save as much money as possible so they can mount a stronger offense in the next round. So this should be an easy round here for Area 51, but you never know, especially with four T250s in the house. Abe, however, does play the long game, and gets a ranged shot on Relic's head.
Just trying to play it methodically. That's all this is about. Minimize losses. Maximize returns. It's all business here for Area 51 as they mow down Savage players left and right, racking up the cash and making sure that no one is the worse for it. We have Mo getting sprayed down there with the Galil on Hades. Florian's is left though, left alone to wander. Dust 2, that PT-50. And unless he's able to pull out some magic, unless he's able to enter the Matrix, which is suddenly very relevant, he is going to find himself at a loss. Terrorists
win. Nice peeking there by the opposing side, coming out from two angles at the same time, so even if he does manage to get one frag, the second guy will definitely take him out and limit the further damage he can do to that team. Mo going to be on the AWP again. We've got Valens now on the FAMAS, a French gun. Can see the French army walking around with that in Gare du Nord if you ever go to Paris. Ooh, the leg shot through the wall. That's not even. And Glorin's gonna take out Aria here. But we've got two frags coming in for the T5, so advantage Area 51.
Yeah, they're coming back strong now into the T side, as we see Disciple was the man to make the two entry frags onto the site. And Mo now in position over at middle, and if Relix decides to go up that way, he is a very, very dead man. And Relix will find himself with a peek, slowly going to try to escape though, on 17 points of health, trying to save this weapon, trying to keep alive the chances in the next round, despite the fact that they're going to be facing a terrible buy. But perhaps that M4 in the mix might allow them to do some extra damage and maybe pick up some weapons on some teammates. There have become possibilities if he's able to keep this M4 alive. And he does spot Abe in the back, so that's going to be nice. Oh, but he wanted to go for the AK, and in doing so, exposed himself. And that was the mistake that cost him the gun. And that's certainly going to leave a bitter, sweet taste in his mouth after taking that frag.
Area 51. Giving Savage a taste of their own medicine here on the T side. Catching up, definitely. It was I think it was 10-5 at half-time, and now all of a sudden they've won four rounds in a row. And again, they've got a strong push into the B site here. Why they have a pincer movement. Disciple taking down players on A. That's two down, Hayes and Glorins. And all of a sudden, Kud is the last man standing here. The CZ is going to run around, try and get a frag. Oh, he's going to go for the T. He was reloading their area, but he got shot in the back by Mo before he could get through the double doors. And that's going to be a great play by Area 51 to bring it back to 10-10, and somewhat quickly, I might add.
Well, Hades, there is an H there, if I can read, is going to be up on the AWP. And he's going to be seeing what he can accomplish that. Oh, wow, he gets the elbow shot there onto Nozzle. That is not pretty, is it? As he does back away. And Alex is going to take down Disciple.
Relic's following the tracer fire through the smoke there. Nice play by him.
And Kud is just there waiting with Glorians on middle for the double middle setup, the crossfire setup there that they can use should there be a push onto that middle area. But here comes Hades once again with a nice shot onto Arya, who challenged the angle. And Mo trying to crab walk his way onto a bit of an angle there himself. And Abe is going to go down as well. So all being picked apart one at a time. And I realize that potentially accidentally there, James, I may have been perpetuating a bit of a stereotype that Cockney, people that speak in a Cockney accent sound like Dick Van Dyke. With the 80s thing. Counter-terrorists
win. 80s.
Do you know the reference I'm talking about? Like the Dick Van Dyke playing the dude in Mary Poppins, and he was just like a Dutch guy that put on a really bad Cockney accent, but a lot of people associate that with how Brits speak.
I have no recollection of any content from the Mary Poppins.
You don't know Mary Poppins? What is this? How dare you sit next to me?
I'm too esports for Mary Poppins.
Too esports for Mary Poppins. All right, well, we're going to have a big assault there with all the flashes in the world used on that long approach to try to secure it. Disciple going to go in, getting his hands dirty there, and going to find the headshot onto Glorians. Glorians only with one frag, so that's going to be a long taken over, but you know what? Hades has something to say about it. Kud has something to say about it. They're going to make their way on to that stop there, but oh, Disciple going to get himself another kill, and that's going to be a long, once again, taken by Area 51 and held onto.
Indeed, and it's a two-man advantage here for Area 51. Savage may try to retain their guns, but it looks like they're trying to get the damage in. Hades does reduce the man deficit with a grenade on a Disciple, and this is doable now for Savage.
Yeah, it looks like they want to go for that B play. Going to spot Relix jumping through the window, and they know that it's one A side, but in comes Relix. Beautiful peek there. Look how blind Nozzle was. He could not see a single thing except the blurred image of Relix as he gunned him down. As now we see it's just all on Mo with the AWP. He's going to be trying to make himself a frag very soon. There goes the peak. Hip shot, not going to connect. As we do see the round going to Savage. They are rising back to prominence like a phoenix from the ashes. They have brought about quite a violent return to this match.
Indeed. Savage, however, with a two-round lead. We are going to see Orbs on Hades and Mo again. Hades, let's see if he can get someone through the doors. Yes, he can. Oh, sorry, no, it's going to be Mo taking out Relix here. So Hades will remain with the Orb, but he'll be glad he missed Mo on that one. We've got fire, we've got flames. Disciple will go down. Farewell to the flesh there. Valencia with a second frag as well. Long will be in control of the T's, though. Two of the three remaining T's. Still got Mo in T spawn for now. Going to be looking for that flank there from the CT playing B. Looks like the flank is coming in. This could start making his way towards A. So let's see who wins the battle of the crossing between Mo and Kud.
Hades has to make a frag. Absolutely. The first time he sees a player and pulls the trigger, if it doesn't result in a kill, their chances rapidly decrease. Or dramatically decrease. And here we go, he does take the first kill, gets a chance for a second shot, gonna whiff that one, and that's gonna be the end of him, as he has at least created a one-on-two situation for Kud, as that is certainly gonna be a little bit more doable. And moving towards long is actually kind of smart, considering that they do have an AWPer. He could have gotten a close one-on-one against an AWPer, but they do actually keep the AWPer to the site. So Kud's gonna go in now, looking to see what he can find. There's a bit of a tag, and fighting for his life as he's slowly bleeding to death. Mo will put him out of his misery with a quick shot, a clean shot, straight to their head.
Okay, so there is a quick pause here. But while this happens, let's have a look at what these guys are doing here. We can see that Kud is currently topping the leaderboard with 21 frags. Mo not far behind on the T side, got 17 frags, Disciple 18 frags. In fact, a lot of these players are pulling their weight, apart from Valens, who is just coming up a little bit short at the moment. It is 12-11 to his team, however. He does have 3 assists, so things going well.
But I'm sure he has a great personality.
We've got Aria with a huge amount of assists here. We've got 8 assists on Aria and 6 on Hades. So those guys doing the meat shots there and allowing their teammates to finish things off, get those assist points. How do you feel about what's going on at the moment, DDK?
Bloodbath. It is chaos. It is a lot of... I think I've seen a lot of really nice entries from Disciple, actually. I mean, he's only on 18 frags, but the thing is about the stats is that it doesn't necessarily tell the whole... Well, it doesn't tell the whole tale, as it's how meaningful the frags are. I mean, there is a term that Threat uses, for those who know who Threat is, I'm sure many will. He calls it Grimsing, which is it refers to a player who's called Grims, who always... would actually just stay on the flank and just like bait his entire team to get kills, and his stats would always look really good, but he was actually making loads of kills that were completely negligible, basically, and they didn't even matter or have an impact. We're seeing a lot of impactful frags on the entries from Disciple. As we move into the next round, already Mo is going to pick up a nice entry onto Long. Hades does have an AWP in his hands over towards Short, but this is a pretty awkward defense, as Glorians will be quickly isolated. There's nowhere for him to fall back. This is one of those positions where if you get caught, you're done. And that's it. Are you going to take him out? A swift bullet to the head, and that's all that was needed. And all of a sudden, a huge amount of pressure on Hades and his teammates in kind to try to make some frags back here as the smokes go down. Hades is going to edge onto the angle with the AWP. Gets flashed back. Can't quite seem to get the engagement. And Abe's going to take him down, and it's all on relics. And there's so little for him to do against 4 players. Surely this is something that's a bit too insurmountable. But Relix is going to try to see what he can do, and no.
12-12 now between these two teams. Quite literally nothing between them, other than this eco that Savage are going to have to do. Now, they have their money in a place where they have to be careful, very careful, as to what they buy. We can see the P250s coming out on a flashbang on Hades. He's not going to throw that flash at the very beginning. Valens with a flash as well. No one else is going to challenge Mo for the time being, although he probably will have counted how many people went to B. Only 1, it seems, which means that 2 are going to be elsewhere. That also means that B does have a vulnerability, basically, and he will see if he can capitalize on it.
And they're going to go in for the entry here towards Short onto that site, and he does find one as Nozzle does also over towards B. So losing players at B, losing players at A and middle. What is Savage to do? The most oppressive of situations for them, as we do see Disciple trying to tag him down, but it's going to be hard to find the frag. And Hades left alive, the last man standing. In the most depressing of situations, 18 points of health. One had a flash, very cute, but unfortunately it was just too much to handle for him as Area 51 take a lead, and we will get the buy coming in from Savage, but it leaves a lot to be desired.
Indeed, it leaves an AWP desired, as Hades does not have the money here, so he's going to have to go for the M4. We'll see what kind of difference it makes in this round. Mo, once again, bringing out the AWP. He is getting some huge frags in for his team at the moment, and they are going to have the 1-round advantage. So the question is, are Area 51 going to run away over here? Valens with the FAMAS, and you can see only Glorians with a helmet on his team. Loads of nades, reasonable amount of nades. Savage will be able to smoke off Area 51 for just a little bit, but eventually time will tell who the strongest team is.
Looks like Glorians is already in waiting, raring to go. but it's not to be just yet, as the tease will move slowly further and further away from Aelong. Although it is Avi who is slowly making his way back, as the A split does become quite a possibility now for Area 51. Although the B split can be said the same for that, as it all depends now on the picks and the information that they can find. And they do have Aria trying to make himself a bit of an entry up towards short and the A site, but then the smoke deters him. So looks like they might just go out for middle then instead. And here they are together, making the slow push through as Savage try to respond. It's going to be difficult though, and Mo going to find a tag, I believe, and does finish off Cut. In fact, Disciple giving him a hand as well, as Relic's at the back of the site may not find himself in a more important round in recent time, as he is having to pick them away with the M4. He's running out of bullets very soon, switches to the USP, but already he's going to get taken out, as it's a 2-on-2 now. Retake coming in. He did manage to take down one player. Zarya goes in for the quick peek. Perhaps he times it right. It's all over for Hades. It's curtains. And there it is. Great snap there onto Zarya. The beautiful response as he goes in. And that's it. Nozzle takes the frag against Hades. And that's going to be the round there for Area 51 as they go 14-12. And Savage, what are they going to do? Look at the money. It's depressing for them.
Mo bought a Negev by accident. Look at how much money he spent, $11,500. He bought a Negev by accident, and he will leave it in T-spawn and go for the AWP. So smoke's coming down in the middle of the map. No one going to be found. It's going to give the CTs more safe passage towards the B bomb site. The T's trying to get aggressive here on long. The T's, Area 51 seems to know that the CTs are on an eco here. And indeed, they are going to be up against CZ-75s and P250s. Savage just holding angles, trying to build up crossfires. But Area 51 refuse to be baited right now.
Yeah, they're behind all the doors at the moment. So I have to see Aria if he can make himself a frag. There goes the unhanded smoke. That's really nice because it gets him behind the smoke into more wider angles. He can play together. It looks like the frag will be returned by Abe in the end. As it looks like over in middle, Valens and is going to find himself a frag as well, so things are looking a little bit better, but the pistols are going to have to do for now. That's a great headshot. Where did that come from? Card showing some skills there, as Avi is going to warily back his way as he holds the clip there. He's back in as he's going to spot Valens once again. Here he's going to go for the finishing blows. He's going to find them. There it is, just the bursts of the AK should be enough, and the controlled fire from Abe, the cool, composed technique of that AK-47 will do the job there to put them onto match point.
Indeed, that was great play there by Abe, and great control of his gun there. You can see him tapping at the end. Doesn't want to mess around with some long-range spraying. Just tap, 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 took out the last remaining CT there and brought his team into match point. Mo looking for a frag through the middle doors. Nobody going to be found there as the other CT does go through to the B bomb site. We have an aggressive push here from Hades with the AWP on short. He is looking lower tunnels as well, but we'll get shot straight up from mid by Mo.
And it's going to be very awkward now. Valens is there by Graffiti. This is a really nice position, actually. Peeking is inadvisable against the AWP of Mo. We can see that it's trained on Graffiti right now. It's definitely going to be painful if Valens does go for the peek. And we're going to see Area 51 make their way in slowly. We have Cud from below, trying to get some damage done. Pulls up the USP. Oh, he does get out of there. I don't understand how he even managed to do that, as a Disciple does take down Valens, who was indeed by Graffiti. So, a very easy take. Area 51 blasting their way through the players of Savage. Savage looks so good at multiple points, and Glorians is trying to make this happen. He does have four players left now. He's got to find the ace, picks up the AWP. Not going to find much as he gets blinded and finally removed from the map by Mo. So, Area 51, they picked Dust2. They won Dust2. Savage, it is time for Nuke for them. And anything you want to say before we hit up the break, before setting up the next map?
It was a good start from Savage at the beginning. They had great momentum there, but they just got caught up with by Area 51. So great play, good comeback from them, and really strong AWPing and fragging in general from both teams. But it ended up being Area 51, all their teammates chipping in fairly evenly, not awkwardly, to bring them the W in map one of this best of three.
Right, we had a final headshot counter of 61 there, so we'll leave you with that as it's time for a break, and we'll be back with Nuke says don't go anywhere.